Welcome everybody to another episode, another act of Glitched Out Wrestling. Now we are kicking off tonight with Logan Paul defending his Hardcore Glitch Championship against Blade. Blade, who has the most successful title defenses as the Hardcore Glitch Champion, versus Logan Paul, who is one of the longest reigning Hardcore Glitch Champions. I say one of because he is tied with Gabriel after taking the belt from Gabriel last week. If Gabriel had won that battle royal, then he'd be the longest reigning, but oh my god. However, Logan Paul is the first and only two-time Hardcore Glitch Champion. Now that can change if Blade wins the title here tonight, but will that change? Logan Paul's out here to make sure that doesn't change. But oh my god, slapping him across the chest, and now a punch to the bridge of the nose, and now a Russian leg sweep from Logan Paul. Now these two, I don't think these two like each other very much, honestly. Blade with a double stomp. Logan Paul was getting up, but Blade stopping him, a neck breaker, into a splash, a handspring splash, maybe something like that. And now Logan Paul taking Blade and hitting a DDT. And now Blade with a kip up, and oh my god, a springboard into an enziguri. Running around, Logan hitting that springboard enziguri, Logan kicking out at one. Blade readying his shot, it seems, but no, because Logan, Irish whip, oh my god, an elbow to the bridge of the nose. God damn, that could end very badly. That could be a broken nose right there. Now Logan, Logan taking too long, gloating, gloating, and took a kick to the side of the skull after coming off the ropes. And now, oh my god, a headbutt to the dick. That's gotta hurt. There's no way that does not hurt. I mean, obviously that hurts. Oh, and now targeting the leg, maybe. Oh, and Blade targeting the arm, and god damn, that'll have your shoulder aching for a good week, maybe. Probably not, honestly. I'm lying on my ass, I'm not gonna lie. And now Logan with a knee to the face. I'm gonna say Blade and then Logan reverse, but it worked out in the end, I guess. Now Logan Paul onto the apron, and that clothesline, there's that clothesline, that flipping, I don't even know what to call it, but one, two, the Paul shot lariat is what we're gonna call it here on Glitch Out Wrestling. The Paul shot lariat, the Logan shot lariat, either way, he hit it. And now, Blade with a springboard into a drop kick. And now, one, shoulders up. Logan kicks out at one. And now Blade, oh my god, Blade stomping on the elbow. And Blade still, oh my god, holding the arm as he kicks his head in, kicks his ribs in. And now twisting at the arm. And now grabbing the other arm and twisting at the wrist. God damn, and oh my god, knees to the back. And now Blade stomping on the leg. And now stomping on the elbow again. And now Logan stumbling to his feet. His arms hurting. And Blade with the spear. My goodness. And now Logan getting up to his feet. And Blade's not done. Blade with the nightmare. That could be it right there. We have a new Hardcore Glitch Champion. Three. Blade is now a two-time Hardcore Glitch Champion alongside Logan Paul. Now, congratulations to Blade on winning. I know he's feeling himself. He's happy he won that title back. He took it from Goldberg. He lost it to Gabriel. And he took it back from Logan Paul after Logan took it from Gabriel. Blade, I know Blade's happy. Congratulations to Blade on winning his championship here tonight. And our next match is one I've personally been waiting for. Nick Natural versus Jay Marshall. Deuce. Two times. These two men will be going at it two times for the second time. And now, oh, Nick Natural jump right out the gate, starting off with a little bit of heat on him. A little hot. Pause. Because Nick Natural's got to be a little angered with Jay Marshall as, oh my god. Oh, and I forgot what it's called. Oh, an intercon device. Not being able to lock it in fully, but locking it in enough. But Jay Marshall breaks out of it. Now, these two might... Maybe, honestly. Nick Natural might hate Jay Marshall right now. But I don't think the feeling's mutual. Jay Marshall's just in it to win it type shit. These two men both came into Glitched Out Wrestling the same way. Answering an open challenge from... the former King of Glitch, Aaron Kenneth, and they both lost their debut match to Aaron Kenneth, but in their second match, they faced each other, a one-on-one, in the tournament that would crown a new King of Glitch, and, well, Jay Marshall wanted the win, and he was willing to do anything he wanted to get that win, including... winning via countout. Now, oh, a springboard clothesline from Jay Marshall. And now Nick Natural wants that win back. And he's gonna get it back with this clothesline. That clothesline taking his fucking head off. Two shoulders up. And now Nick Natural knows he's not done. He's gonna hit that DDT, that Naturalist DDT. One, two, oh my god, shoulders up. No, because. And now, Nick Natural up top with an elbow drop. He misses. He does not get all of it. Nick Natural is just not letting Jay Marshall get any hits on him because, like I said, he's probably pissed. He's not. He doesn't even want Jay Marshall to fight back, probably. I mean, maybe he does because. Where's the fun in that type shit? But Nick Natural wants to win fair and square, while Jay Marshall again will do anything he can. Jay Marshall rolling out the ring. I think it might be a good idea if Nick Natural does not follow him, but Nick Natural's not gonna listen as Nick Natural slides out the ring. Last time they were out like this, Jay Marshall picked up the victory via countout. So let's see, it might happen again here as Jay Marshall targeting the arm, doing one-arm push-ups on Nick Natural. And now, Nick Natural, Jay Marshall's actually going to Irish whip Nick Natural into the ring this time. Kind of a little surprising here. Jay Marshall, though, getting dropped on his back with that beautiful teardrop suplex. And now, oh, dropped into the Anaconda Vice again. And now Nick Natural still not having it fully locked in. He's got it locked in. Oh, but Jay Marshall's fighting out of it. And now Jay Marshall. Oh my god. Nick Natural getting planted. No, Jay Marshall getting planted. Oh, but here comes the Naturalist DDT for the second time. That could end it there, but he's got to move away from the rope so there's not a rope break, showing off his ring genius. But one, two, shoulders up, him moving him away from the ropes may have taken a little too much time for him to capitalize. It may have just cost him the match, as Jay Marshall is immediately going to do his own damage with that Uranagi. Jay Marshall not talking shit. Nick Natural just right back up though. And oh my god, a boot to the face of Nick Natural. And now Jay Marshall picking Nick Natural up in a neck breaker. A neck breaker. Oh, and Jay Marshall. Oh, never mind. I thought Jay Marshall must be feeling himself. He definitely scared Nick Natural. But Nick Natural going to punish him, as Nick Natural going for that clothesline again, taking his head off. Is he going to go for the pin? He's not even going to go for the pin. He's going to let Jay Marshall get up, and he's going to hit the Naturalist DDT for the third time in the center of the ring. 1, 2, 3. Nick Natural gets his win back. Nick Natural is 1-1 against Jay Marshall. Jay Marshall had his number going into this, and now they're one apiece. But Nick Natural's got the momentum. Let's see if he can keep it. Congrats to Nick Natural on getting his win back. In our main event, Ruben Otison versus the returning Billy Cole. And now, Ruben Otison. Oh my god. Billy Cole running off out the gates. And now immediately getting a German suplex. Ruben Otison. What a powerbomb. Ruben Otison looking to get revenge on Billy Cole for his younger brother, Aaron Kenneth. The former King of Glitch, by the way. Knowing we had Blade and Ruben Otison, family members of Aaron Kenneth, Jay Marshall, and Billy Cole weren't suspended for attacking Aaron Kenneth. They were suspended to keep them safe from this man right here, who was gonna clothesline Billy Cole's fucking head off. And now, what was I saying? Like zoned out. God damn. Oh my fucking goodness. Punching the shit out of Billy Cole, stomping his face in, and now a boot to the side of his skull. Goodness gracious. Ruben Otison climbing up top. He's going for a splash, and oh my god, Billy Cole moved out of the way. Billy Cole going to attack Ruben Otison eats that kick to the back of the head. Oh, Billy Cole hits a head toss, and Billy Cole's feeling himself, and Billy Cole gets sent across the fucking ring. God damn. Ruben Otison, not very happy with Billy Cole. He's gonna send Billy Cole to the outside of the ring. Billy Cole stunned on the ground. Ruben Otison slowly walking over, menacingly, wee woo, wee woo, wee woo, pounding his face in with that gauntlet of his, and now slamming him down, picking him up by the face and just slamming him back down into the steel, and once again doing it two times. God damn. And now, waiting inside the ring. And now, going to jump over the fucking ring, god damn. And now Ruben Odinson sending Billy Cole back into the ring and grabbing him by the feet, and he's gonna pick him up and slam his knee back down. God damn, that's very, very bad. Very, very bad. And oh my god, picking him up and sending him overhead. Ruben Odinson. He's going to kill Billy Cole. Doing it twice in a row. Two times. And now, Ruben Odinson picking up Billy Cole and planting him, dropping him face first into the ground, into the mat. I don't know why I said ground, but whatever. And now, god damn, a nasty uranage, and Ruben Odinson climbs up to the top rope, looking for it a second time, maybe a splash. God damn, that could be it right there. One, two. Oh my god, Billy Cole kicked out. And now Ruben off the rope. And oh my god, dropping his knees on him. That could kill a man. With the knees the size of Ruben's, that's gonna kill a man. And now, oh my god. Ruben basking in his own glory. And now, that's the signs of other members of Pitch Black. Jay Marshall could be anywhere, as he's set to be, he's in the arena tonight. Oh, roll up. One, two. Oh my god, Ruben Odinson barely getting out. Oh my god, and he's, oh my goodness, Billy Cole might have just died. And now Ruben Odinson, oh my goodness, the RKO Ruben's knockout. One, two, three. Ruben Odinson picking up the victory here tonight against Billy Cole. My mind completely blanked there. The fuck? Billy Cole getting basically murdered by Ruben Odinson tonight. That is a scary dude. I don't know. He's out for revenge. That's a man out for revenge for his family. Congratulations to Ruben Odinson on picking up the victory here against Billy Cole.